important because every company has a certain eligibility criteria for GPA. Some companies require 7, 7.5 or 8.5, something like this. And other than this, also all the companies are not open for all the branches. Certain companies allow only circuital branches to be eligible. But you don't need to worry more about the branch thing because there are many companies which are open to all. So, but still you need to consider GPA as an important factor because sometimes what happens is in the coding rounds, many people are able to score the highest score. So in that case, the company decides the GPA to be the second factor in considering the shortlist of the candidates. So yeah, GPA is very important as compared to branch. There was a coding round and then three rounds of interview. So in the coding round, there were two medium and one easy level question. And in the first round of interview, it was mainly based on problem solving skills. And other than this, they asked two, three questions on my project and some system design based questions. So in the coding questions, they asked two questions mainly on graphs. And after this round, there was a second round of interview, again based on problem solving mainly. And it consisted of a single question, but the interviewer tried to ask many questions out of it. Like first I told my approach, then he told me to optimize it to time complexity of O of n log n, then to time complexity of O of n, then a space complexity of O of n in such a way that the question was extended up to half an hour, you can say. And in the third round, the HR round was there, and in the HR round, he asked mainly problem solving questions, but not related to data structure algorithms. It was something, you can say, system design level questions. Like he told, if you are the system testing engineer at Microsoft and you are needed to test an elevator, so how would you test it? So you can say he asked some real life problems. And he also asked some very in-depth questions related to my project. So you can say this round was based on mainly two things, the project and the real life problems. Firstly, be confident in whatever you are speaking, and secondly, when you are mentioning your introduction, that time just don't speak of your nameplate branch. Try to be technical. You can speak of any past internship or any past project if you have done. If you have some good achievements, you can speak that too. Also mention your technical interests. This is what the company is looking for. Specifically in coding questions, first of all, try to explain your approach to the interviewer. If the interviewer gives you a green signal, then only start coding. If you are not getting any idea regarding how to solve a particular question during an interview, then try to think of all the data structures you have studied one by one. This will help a lot. Many times the interviewers ask the common question at the end, "Do you have a question for me?" So don't remain silent at this time and try to ask something related to the technologies the company is using. Or ask anything which shows your interest towards the company. This will help you a lot. It actually depends. If the question is on a topic which you don't know much about, then try to say that you have not studied that particular topic. But otherwise, you must try to explain your approach to the interviewer, how you are approaching towards the correct answer. Because many times the interviewers ask questions with the intention to know your thought process. So it might be very helpful in that time. We'll be right back. having 2-3 good projects is important. It has a great advantage because if you have worked on some real life projects, then it shows that you are interested in solving some real life problems. And other than this, it is a great advantage because you would be saved from some unseen algorithmic questions asked by the interviewer, as he would have less time to ask you. While explaining about it, first of all, explain the problem statement, then explain how did you solve that problem in brief. And after that, just mention the tech stack you have used. And after that, just ask the interviewer that you can tell him more if he wants to know. This would be enough. And because generally the interviewer would ask you some more questions about the project, like what problems or challenges did you face during the project and how did you overcome those and many more. Yes, soft skills do matter, but soft skills are not everything. Means you must be able to explain your approach clearly to the interviewer. You must be able to understand it. That's it. But yes, participation in clubs and co-curricular activities do help a lot in brushing up our soft skills. Your resume should include 2-3 good projects or work experiences. Also mention the relevant links to show your originality. And in skills, try to mention all those skills which you have learned apart from those in the curriculum. And do mention in your achievements if you secured a decent rank in any worldwide contest or a hackathon. One mistake which I observed was that people start solving very high level problems from platforms like Codeforces, CodeChef, etc. during the last 2 months of preparation. So this should be avoided. One must focus more on solving problems from LeetCode, InterviewBit or Geeks for Geeks during the last 2 months of preparation, because these contain the questions which generally we expect during the coding rounds and also during the interviews. And apart from this, one more mistake which I observed was that people ignore topics like operating systems, object-oriented programming, or system design. But generally in interviews, these questions are asked. So just you must go through the main concepts involved in these, and you can go through the main concepts in about 4 to 5 days, and that would be sufficient to answer the questions of the interviewer. You would be easily able to answer those. So don't leave those topics, I would say. Firstly, try to avoid speaking about something which you don't know much about. For example, if the interviewer asks you that what is the thing which you like the most in your computer architecture course, and suppose you don't know how to implement a LRU cache and you speak that thing only, then that would be not a good thing. And another thing which I would like to mention specifically for the coding questions is that don't directly jump to the optimized solution. First, you should understand the question well, and if you think that the question is incomplete, then ask the clarifications from the interviewer. And after you know the question well, then try to explain a brute force approach first to the interviewer, then gradually try to optimize it. In this way, you would be saved from any probable errors. We'll be right back. The best interview experience which I had was the HR round with Microsoft, because first of all he asked really very in-depth questions related to my project and I really liked to explain him those. And apart from this, he asked me very unexpected questions from you can say real life problems, and still I was able to answer those in a proper way using my system design skills. To my batchmates, I would like to say that just before the actual round of interviews, try to give at least 3 to 4 mock interviews to different people. This would really help to boost your performance during the actual interview. And to my juniors, I would like to say that first of all, maintain a decent GPA, because GPA is really important in every stage of the internship process. And apart from this, also you should have 2 to 3 good projects to mention in your resume. And at this stage, don't practice on platforms like Geeks, LeetCode or InterviewIt. This would hamper your thinking capability. So try to practice on Spodge, Codeforces, HackerRank or platforms like these. And also take part in competitions like Hackathon, Google Kickstart, Facebook Hacker Cup and many more.